Welcome back to another video, guys. In this video, we are going to go through this Mazda. Engine management light does come on due to the DPF being full. Now, all I'm doing today is showing you the capability of the brand new Icarsoft CR MAX BT. Now, I'm going to show you the functions and what it's capable of doing. So, we have plugged it in. We've got the extender, which I like. I mean, some diagnostic machines don't have the extender, which this does, because it's a nightmare to plug this in sometimes in where the hole is, shall we say. So we'll start off. I like how it looks. This is the machine, by the way. Brilliant piece of kit. Can't go wrong. It is solid, shall we say. There's no messing around. Now, it's an auto VIN detect. So if we go on and if we find, for example, let's say this is Mazda, if we do this, we get Mazda, and here is where it's going to detect the other side. You can hear the beep, you can hear the red light. There we go. So that's pairing up to this. Now we do auto identify, switch on ignition, our engine is running. Hit okay. It is a brilliant piece of kit, by the way, and the best thing about it, it's free lifetime updates, so you can't go wrong. You're not having to pay hundreds of pounds for yearly updates. It's literally bargain, in other words. So I'm not going to do an auto scan. I'll show you anyway. I have already cleared the fault. We'll do an auto scan so you can get an idea of how quick the thing goes through it. Car for car variants. Mercedes is the worst one for it to be, for you to use any diagnostic machine on it, because it takes forever. Mazda, okay. BMW, very quick in general. However, the Icarsoft is doing so far so good. So this is a 2.2 diesel engine. They are the Ford engines, as far as I know. I could be wrong, but I'm sure it is. They have the 2 liter as well. They're very bad for DPF issues. So we are gonna, because the car goes into limp mode, so we are going to eliminate the engine management light that comes on here and there. If it does concentrate, it doesn't, but I am. 76%. I like how it tells you what percentage it is. Some of them do tell you up here the percentage. So let's have another few seconds. So it should be done now. There we go. So, as you can see, it's quick as that. There's no faults, obviously, it's all being sorted, but I'm going to show you what it's capable of doing. Control units is, again, the modules that it just went through now. So service is where we, for us to reset, let's say you put a new DPF in, go into control module, data reset, okay. And here is the DPF. If you've put a MAF sensor, you do that, O2 sensor, you do that. So you hit DPF. Sometimes, just so you all know, it doesn't work trying to do a DPF regen. So reality is, it's only best, oh look at that, it's pretty damn quick. It's only best if you reset the DPF to say it's had a new DPF and then go and do a regen. So initialization, that's fine. You've got a lot of functions, as you can see there, it's like plenty of functions you can reset within the engine control module. All reset, this does come up. We'll do that, okay. So as you can see, it is fully okay. That's fine, not that one. Oh, it's because I've got the ignition off, naughty me. There we go, we need the ignition on. There we go, boom, done. You can enter it this way, but yeah, I'm not going to go through all this, guys. I'm just going to show you the basics of what it's capable of. It tells you 98% switch off the ignition. With Ford, Mazda and all these, and Vauxhall, you will have to turn the ignition on and off here and there. Anyway, back to our topic. So we're going to do a diesel particulate filter. Diesel particulate filter DPF regen. So, okay. Fine. Apply neutral, position engine start idling. So we have the handbrake up. Okay. P. Okay. Let's let it communicate. So it needs to be at least 70 degrees, which is at 81 degrees because I've had the engine running. And then the precision may take 60 minutes. Do you want to continue? Of course I do. Hit continue. DPF is in progress, so it's going to kick the revs up. As you can see, I have not put my foot on there. My foot is there, guys. Look. There you are. and it's kicking in. And now, if we go around the back, obviously it will start kicking out all sorts of I can already smell a lot of fumes coming out. There's a lot of fumes coming out of this. And once the engine gets to a certain degree, it will start burning all the soot and off it comes out through the back end. And then the only thing I'll say, guys, is just keep an eye on the engine temperature and make sure it's not overheating, because this does put a lot of strain on the engine. And I'll also say, once you've done a DPF regen, what we would recommend is you actually do an oil change service, because it's quite a harsh procedure on the engine. What I love about it is, look, it's Bluetooth, so we're not having to worry about, oh, it's going to disconnect. So as you can see, the revs are already where they should be. So we'll leave it to do the procedure. It'll also auto reset itself afterwards as well. It has done it. What we'll need to do is to switch ignition off. So, which is off. As you can see, it's as simple as that. There's nothing much, there's nothing crazy about it. But like I said, guys, it is a brilliant key, you know, piece of kit. You can't go wrong. Service back into here. There's so many things we can do. There is quite a lot of things it is capable of. But that was just one of the main functions. And like I said, it's free update for life, so you can't go wrong. And they are quite quick at responding, so if you did email them whatsoever, they'll be on it straight away. And coding injectors, I'm not going to do it, I don't want to fiddle with it much, but you can code in injectors, tire pressure, warning reset, air conditioning, seat, cruise control, adaptive cruise control. I mean, you can reset the calibration of the adaptive cruise control, especially when they change the, on VAG cars, Audi CS code VW, when they change the windscreen or the front bumper, there's that radar thing. If they fiddle with it, you can do it with this way. I'm not going to go into it in too much detail. Control unit, again, like we said, this is the engine. And what I like about it as well, so you can do a view data, which is like a live data. So let's see what it brings and how it brings it. But it's really important, especially in this game. So like if you, I don't know, wanting to exactly like this one, the DPF, you want to check out the soot content and whatnot, you just go into it in this way. And it kind of tells you. So as you can see, you want to search for something quite, you know, you don't want to go through all these. We'll just type in suit. Suit. There we go. Where's the enter button? That's a good question. Oh, there it is. Maybe it doesn't bring it. Let's type in DPF. State of the DPF, so I think it's this way. Every manufacturer has different wording. But I'll just show you the other things that it brings. So AC, distance, trouble cleared, okay. There's a lot of things it covers, which is amazing. Wow. Engine oil. I'm not going to bore you guys too much, but you can already see what I'm talking about here. DPF indicator, like that's brilliant. So, coming back out of this, actuation test is like, I don't know. Look, EGO, hit it to see if it works. Injectors, I don't know. There's things you can activate and not activate, in other words. So it's pretty good that you've got that option as well. But There's nothing crazy about this machine. It's a brilliant piece of kit. I will put the link in so you guys can actually find more details about it. And if you did fancy it, you can also buy one online as well. I'll show you the other bit to it, which I haven't shown yet. So these two pieces, they come separate. Obviously, it still comes part of the deal. I like it. It's Bluetooth, very handy. you won't lose it. And I love the fact that you can put it literally down there like that. You'll never lose it, ever. And this is an extender, especially for Vauxhall products, for Ford products. It's hard to put that in because it's a bit chunky, so you use this extender, which is good stuff. But yeah, there you are, guys. Any questions, put in the comment. You know, I'd like to see your reviews. I'd like to see your feedback. I'd like to see what you guys think. If there is something better than this, let me know. It'd be nice to reach out and see what other manufacturers can provide. And I'd like to share it with you all. But my opinion and experience is it's a brilliant piece of kit. And the fact that it's very, very, very user-friendly in comparison, it's very comparable to Autel, which we all know. Autel's a brilliant piece of kit, but very, very near overpriced. But that's not for me to decide, that's for you all to decide.